Prof, spiral dynamics, what an interesting concept. What does it stand for?
It's a concept developed by Dr. Don Beck, who was a student of C.W. Graves. And it basically, spiral dynamics in principle is a very powerful tool to understand human development and cultural evolution. And the idea of the spiral comes from the work that Beck and C.W. Graves did when they said humans in their development of their thinking and their value systems, because of changing circumstances and life conditions, they change and move to higher levels of thinking, higher levels of value systems, but they never shed the old ones, but they go to higher levels, and this spirals up, and it's a continuous spiral going up. And spiral dynamics as a tool gives you insight into this development of thinking and values, and hence the concept of spiral dynamics.
You have come up with the idea of inviting Don Beck back to South Africa after he was quite deeply engaged in the transformation processes that we went through in the late 80s and the beginning of the 90s. Why did you propose that, and why is it important for now?
I met Don many years ago in the transformation and going from before 94 to after 94. I've read his books, and I got a deep insight into the kind of the body of knowledge that they bring and the tools that they have and the insights that they have that played a big role in many of our current leaders in the country in their thinking and thinking differently. And now after many years, I think it's time where we are all now in one big crucible almost. All these groupings that we have, each with their own realities, constructed by themselves, their value systems, their beliefs, their experiences. We now have to live together as South Africans. And spiral dynamics, I believe, and that's why we are bringing Don Beck out, will give us an insight into how do human beings think? What is the core of their thinking? What is underlying that? And looking from a biological side, from a psychological side, from a sociological side, from a spiritual side, so that once we understand that, that we can, as leaders and as change agents, that we can actually facilitate this transformation that we need, that we facilitate the kind of changes we want in our organizations and what we want in society.
So someone who has gone through this process of training together with Don, what will such a person be better able to do as a result of that, and whom do you think will actually gain the most benefit as a result of attending the Spiral Dynamics workshop?
Any manager or any leader that takes his or her role serious in this country should benefit a lot from this. Not necessarily walking away from this session or this intervention with a recipe, but my hope is, from past experience, that their thinking will be heavily challenged and that they would go away almost with a deep insight into what makes up people's reality, how do people construct their reality, and give them an insight how to deal with those different realities and how to facilitate as a leader in an organization, in society, in the public sector, wherever we operate as leaders, how do we facilitate amongst this immense diversity with an understanding of this typical diversity and the kind of thinking that we encounter and the kind of realities that we encounter. How do we facilitate our normal work with this understanding to create the kind of transformations we want in our organizations and in society? Just on a personal note, I think Don Beck is process in motion when you experience him. He's really well established in this field, and he brings a powerful body of knowledge and he facilitates it exceptionally well. And I think it's a unique opportunity.
Maybe we can just confirm then the venue and the details. The training is happening on the 25th to the 27th of November at Speer Wine Estate. What a lovely place to have such an event taking place.
Well, that's consistent with spiral dynamics. If we create the right conditions, we can move the thinking to a higher level in that environment.
Excellent. Thank you.